Hi, I'm sure I've already done a small review on the Megan. Muffins Is My Lover has reviewed it. Pretty Black has reviewed it. And also Roticia has reviewed it. And what they showed me in their reviews was how full and pretty the wig is and how different it looks from the picture that you get when you purchase it, which I did say, and I didn't promise you all, but I did say I was going to have the pictures ready when I did my reviews. Foiled again! I don't have it ready. But in the picture, she doesn't appear this full. When you put her on, you realize she's very soft, very full. And for everyday wear, this here can get in your way. I believe on the video, she's parted down the middle. I mean, on the card, she's parted down the middle because she doesn't have a lot of lace. I'm not a down the middle kind of gal, I'm to the side. So I had to practice some tricks today, and that's what I'm gonna show you for the everyday new wig wear, what you can do oh, and by the way, I don't have her glued or taped down. She does lift if you pull on her. I mean, you may be seeing some lift here on the side and some lift here on the side because she's not glued down. I had to go somewhere real quick and I wanted to find a wig that had a good fit. Megan has a really tight cap. I also don't have her hooked in the back, but then I have a large head. I think the trick for keeping the hair out of the face is to pin it back. Muffins Is My Lover is good at showing you the tricks for grabbing that little bit of hair and bringing it back and doing a little twisty here in a natural looking kind of way, bringing it back behind the ear, leaving some down, and you don't even see the tracks in there. I brought these little gator clips from Target and just hook it around there like that, and it's kind of youthful without being too youthful for those of us who are a little bit more mature in age, not necessarily mentally, but in age. We don't necessarily want the little girl pins and clips in our hair or blue, you know, too much unless we're going out. For the bang part, what I'm finding is that because it doesn't have much of a part, see that little bitty part, a little bitty part right there. That's all you're gonna get. Then you're gonna hit the tracks. So I kind of brush it over, you know, kind of do a non-part part. But what I'm finding is that when I go down like this, because it has a beautiful wave there. If you brush back with the hair, make it come back, and then bring your bang over that, and bring it back and then kind of roll it over, it takes it out of your face. It looks a bit more natural because it does have a straight hairline. And as I've said before, I don't have hair, so I can kind of put my hairline where I want it. And I give myself a bit more forehead than I naturally had without giving myself an unnatural hairline. So once I pull back some hair, I leave a little bit hanging here, and then I actually pull a little bit from up here, just like a couple of strands. I just pull a little bit loose from up here and just kind of let it do that. And on this side, I brush it back. As you saw, I got my brush, because normally it would be like this, and you'd be trying to do this all day, you know, trying to make it, you know, not bump up right here, because it has a little bit of a bump right here, and I don't have anything under there. So the cap is pretty big, and so it kind of gathers up a little bit at the top if you're not careful. So you either have to wear it really full, because if you try to wear it flat, it's going to, you see that? I don't know if you saw that. See that little bump right there? It's going to give you a bump on the side of all places. So you may want to brush this hair back, you know, which isn't recommended because, you know, it doesn't give you an awfully natural hairline. But you brush it back and then just kind of roll that curl over on your hand. Roll it over on your hand. And that'll give you the nice bang that you want without it being just so in your face all the time and you're always having to fool with it. I found that I ran to the store, I ran to the bank, I had to drive and all that other goulash, and it really didn't cause me to be real distracted with my hair, you know, trying to fiddle with it all the time. Once I got this pulled back, like I said, I got a little bit of it, twisted it kind of tight, not awfully, awfully tight, because I didn't want it to, you know, do an unnatural pull against the tracks that show back here. I was able to hook it back there, put a little bit over my ear, do the little brush. I still have some loose hairs up here from doing that, because I found that when I put the cap on, some of the hair slipped up under the cap, so I had to pull them out. So anyway, this was my everyday look. This was my to the bank, to the store, so that when I go like this and pull it out of my face, if I'm, you know, reaching down for something at the store and I do a throwback, you know, it doesn't expose all that hairline, because I've given it a cove in there by brushing the hair back and then bringing my bang over that. I'm able to pull back my hair without exposing the hairline, or if, because I didn't glue right there, and it does have the little metal pushes on the side. Those don't work with me because of the way my head is shaped. Sometimes those pushes actually make it worse. So I try to keep them fairly straight. But if I don't want to glue it, I also don't want to, when I pull back my hair, pull against that non-glued side. So what I do is, by brushing that hair up and by leaving this little bit here and a little bit kind of some loose hairs here, I'm able to keep the hair pushed out of my face without an occasional oopsie, and I've exposed all of the lace that isn't glued down. So that's just a little tip on Megan. I think she's gorgeous. This is a 1B30, and I'm sure I got her from Rocky Trading, because that's where I got her. I got a big old hunk in Rocky Trading Mall a couple weeks back. I've had her about 2 weeks. I think this is the third time I've worn her. And each time I wear her, I'm learning more and more tricks. No heat. I have her on my no heat, and I do think this is the one I actually might have even tried a little heat on the tip and found that it didn't take heat. If I'm wrong about the heat, I'll double check it. Now, I'm trying to get some ideas on the magnetic rollers. I'll be watching videos from the experts here, Joanne Gray and Muffins Is My Lover and Twinkies, because they do a lot of videos on how to roll the hair that doesn't necessarily take heat. Also, Atia. So I'm going to be watching their videos, because I'm going to order some magnetic rollers, wet the hair, set the hair, see what it does. I said I wouldn't be doing a lot of that, but the hair that has a curl in it, I'd like to keep the curl in it. Not necessarily make it straight, curl it back, but if I could figure out how to do that easily, I might try that. It does cut down on the expense of buying a lot of hair. I did want to have a bevy of hair, which I do, but I wanted to, you know, not necessarily, you run out of room eventually. I don't know if anyone has seen my little wall over there that's growing. So anyway, I just wanted to give you an update on the Megan. I think she's a really pretty looking hair. This is the side. This is the bang. This is the color. This is the fullness. I think she's a very full hair with a, you could actually get more ringlets out of her. I've brushed some of them out because I'm not a ringlet kind of gal. But I guess you can see the hair that's getting in my face. She doesn't shed. I haven't had any shedding. I mean, my brush always seems full of hair, but you know, you can brush her and do whatever. She bounces back really nicely. So anyway, just wanted to give you an update on Megan. Have a great day.